is meant for an adult audience. LoveLine may contain sexually oriented content. Listener discretion is advised.
LoveLine with Adam Carolla and Dr. Drew.
And this is LoveLine. I'm Dr. Drew. He is Adam Carolla, and he'll be here in just a second. The phone number here is 1-800-LOVE-191. Big week coming up tomorrow night. Gary Busey and Adam De La Pena. That's Gary Busey's pain in the ass little sidekick there that follows him around. 311 after that, Less Than Jake. Big week coming up. But right now, we're just going to go directly to the phones. Here we go. This is Joe, San Diego, 24. Joe.
How you doing?
Hey, it's Drew here. What's up?
Hey, Dr. Drew. How you doing?
Good.
I have a question for you. I heard a couple weeks ago you had a caller who said he was having trouble orgasming, and you put it down as he had some kind of, he must have had a history of drug abuse or some kind of abuse. And I have kind of the same issues, but I don't have any history of drugs or sexual abuse. But it takes me about 24 to 48 hours in between the times that I can climax. Is there any kind of medical condition that causes that?
No, you mean... No. Are you on a medication?
No, no medication at all.
So you mean you have to sort of recharge your battery for 2 days?
Yeah, exactly.
No, that's
and
normal.
It causes a lot of tension in the relationship because my girlfriend's not that way, and, you know, every night she wants to kind of get things going, and I have trouble keeping up.
Well, you know, having that sort of desire mismatch is very, very common. There's Mr. Carolla. You missed like 30 seconds. Sit down here.
Hey.
Relax, Daddy.
Look at that. Oh, yeah.
Freeway.
Yeah.
Do you see that thing?
No, what happened?
Oh, I don't know. I thought it was all the freeways.
Oh, no, what happened?
101, just parking lot.
Really?
Not. I guess end of 4th of July or whatever.
No, I saw a bunch of helicopters going on.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So there we go. So it's Loveline.
Hey, good times.
Yeah, good times. And it was a nice effect, though. Adam calls us and he goes, I'm going to be like, phone cuts out.
Oh, look, after we're done with Joe here, which I hope is very soon.
Yeah.
I've had an ass full of this kid, I got to be honest with you. I know he hasn't spoken yet. I got to talk about the cellular service in this this area.
Well, it only goes dead by downtown Los Angeles where nobody drives.
The entire, all right.
Joe. Okay. Joe's got a thing. His girlfriend wants sex every night, takes him 2 days for his battery to recharge, which is more than, you know, that's fine. That's good. Joe's fine. But how do you deal with the girlfriend with the high desire? Does she have, now in this situation, we'd say, does she have any sexual abuse issues?
No, she has nothing in her past at all.
So she just has a high drive. Does she feel rejected when
she goes very easily, often multiple times every night. So it causes a lot of frustration on her behalf when she can't get me to do it, but I can get her to do it.
Listen, one of the things that, now this is going to sound weird, but I've talked to a lot of women that have this multiple orgasm skill.
I haven't.
And I know, you've never met them. I've never met them.
Her tail.
But I've talked to a few, and they have a hard time understanding that there could be any other experience of the orgasm. Many of these women will say to me, well, these women that talk about having to want, they're lying. They're just overstating. No, this is how, that's a different biology that they have. It's a different sort of mechanism. And for them, they're always sort of ready, good to go. She has to understand this is your biology. Just the way if you had a higher drive than she did, she'd have to kind of come to terms with this is your biological reality. And maybe there's other things you can do for her on that night when you can't actually get an erection.
Though, I don't know. I'm always a little suspicious that for a woman, they feel a little bit needy.
Oh, yeah, there's something going on. Yeah. It may not be big, but it's something.
Right.
To feel rejected.
I don't have any trouble with erection. It's just actual climaxing that's the trouble. So, I mean, we often start having sex, and I just can't finish.
Just go down on her, give her an orgasm.
No, the multiple types don't like the going down on so much.
Does she not like that?
Well, no. She doesn't like it all that much. And we have sex, and she has orgasm.
No. Well, actually, everyone has to make your point their point.
Yeah.
All right.
I just said that.
Get rid of Joe.
All right. There you go. Anyway, he's fine.
All right, let's switch seats.
Oh, yeah.
I can't take this.
All right, you ready? And headphones, too.
All right, you ready?
And, yeah,
one,
go.
Two, three.
You can't. Yeah, you can.
Okay. Yeah.
There we go.
Now, hey.
Hey, coffee.
Oh, that's better.
Bye.
Jeez, your head's hot, Drew.
Really?
Yeah. You really must have a high-octane brain or something. You really run these cans hot. All right, so, again, I want to apologize for being a little bit late. I had a funny experience out in the street. A haggard broad screamed at me out front of the studio.
What'd she say?
Well, I normally don't pay too close. Try to ignore most of the posted speed limits and driving regulations and things like that. But when I'm running late, then it's Duke's a hazard.
Yeah.
I'm jumping broken bridges and stuff in the car. I now have such a strong commitment to my not waiting for the red arrow to turn green so I can turn left. when the signal is green.
You go around anybody else that should wait.
Well, this was a good one. Oh. I didn't even slide in behind this broad. I just blew past in the left lane and then just made my turn from the left lane. Now, people get freaked out like, oh, my God, a lunatic has escaped and he's behind the wheel of a motor vehicle. But it's like, let's try to examine the danger factor. You're sitting at the red light, at the red arrow, like the lemming putts you are. There's no other traffic coming in any direction because the light is green and there's no traffic coming the other direction. I'm just making my left turn around you.
And they can sit quietly.
They can sit there quietly.
But you threaten them.
But no, it was perfect timing because as I then pulled up and parked my car, climbed out of my car, the signal had changed and she had turned and stopped the car, told me to F myself. But she was great. She was one of these, there's nothing better than a haggard broad. You know what I mean? That sort of looks like the lead singer from Rush. I don't know why that name just face just
Rush.
Popped into my head. Yeah,
strangely,
you got to look at the band. Go look at a
because I was
Rush
talking about
album.
Them today, and I've never spoken to them my entire life.
Well, there you go. I never spoke about them either. But
how weird is that?
Just looked like that guy. Just that sort of coked up Riverside meth, sort of scrawny broad. Like rather have a chick that had a fat ass and one that had veins in her arms.
Yeah,
you know what I mean.
Yeah,
and then weird sort of. A little too tan, a little too wrinkled, and sort of jaw that looks like it'd crush a yak's femur.
But what?
Hair's all, it's sun blasted. Yeah. They look like they've been blasted with sun. Mm. Sun and sand and cigarette smoke. Just a steady diet of it. Yeah.
But,
and they're
but what
pissed.
Why pissed at you? Because
I don't know. I don't know. And that's the other thing, too, is like, you know, these are the kind of people you could snap over your knee and make into kindling if you had to. I don't know why they're running around at night, you know, telling strange guys to F off. But she slowed her car down, told me to F off. Security guard Andy told her to F herself, and then she screamed another one. It was great. Yeah. All right, but good times.
I like you got your man, Andy, there to tell her.
Yeah, to pipe up, too.
You.
Yeah.
That's good.
Chris?
Yep.
You're 18?
Yep.
Are you on a speakerphone?
No, I'm not.
No, well, that's better then. What's up?
Okay. Adam, man, I was wondering, why is it so hard for big guys to get chicks? I mean, I'm like 5'10", 195, and 18, still no girlfriend. I'm like confused.
Why is that big?
That's pretty big.
It sort of depends how you wear it and where you wear it.
If you wear it
in your face and you wear it in your love handles, it can be big.
Like, see, I wear it more on the shoulder width area because, you know, I used to play football and everything.
First off, 5'10", 195 sounds like a regular size guy.
It's a regular size guy.
But it depends how it's...
But he's telling
distributed.
You chest and shoulders.
Yeah.
Adam, man, the thing is, I came from losing like 30, 40 pounds, so like I still got that big face type look.
Yeah, yeah. You know what I mean? It's the big Buddha head.
Okay.
It's a deal breaker for
exactly.
chicks.
You know what? I've got a huge head.
Chicks? I know. Chicks will go out, happily go out with a guy who's 5'4 and 128 pounds, who's cute.
Mm.
I grew up with these guys. All the guys that did the best with the chicks in like junior high and high school. All these non-threatening guys. All these Tiger Beat guys.
Yeah.
You know, name me like one of these teen heartthrob Tiger Beat poster guys who's a big guy.
No.
Now, of course, it's not going to be a fat guy. But I'm just talking about a guy who's, you know, 6'3 and 210. Carson Daly's probably the biggest of the lot.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he's probably 6'2 and 200 pounds.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, average size of these guys is about 5'7", 140 pounds. They just, people look better smaller.
Mm-hmm.
Everything seems to look better smaller.
Yep.
I don't know what happens when stuff gets big. It goes south.
Well, some photographic and camera, that kind of stuff too.
What about your jugs?
I love them big jugs. Yeah.
Do you?
I like those big
jugs.
No. Do you know that about me?
Never.
Had I mentioned that on the air? Oh, really? Wow, revelation.
Great, do tell.
You're sitting down, Drew? Drew, you thought I was into eyes and hair.
Yeah.
No, jugs.
Oh,
turns out
God.
Jugs.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah, so, you know, but there's all this sort of captain of the football team myth. That's nonsense.
Well, it's not myth.
Best to be spindly.
It just doesn't generate the kind of... romantic appeal, I guess, that the image does. You know, that photographically and on film and on television, the small guy sort of creates an image that.
No, but you know, I'm gonna take it a step further. The big strapping captain of the football team is the kind of guy a guy would like if he was a chick.
Yeah.
But chicks, since they even like chicks,
right?
I mean, women are very attracted to the feminine form, right?
Yet though, women, when they sort of, they will say like, oh, I feel safe when I'm in his arms as a big guy kind of thing. They like that feeling.
There's a handful of them, but mainly they like a guy. Actually, they feel safer when they could kick their boyfriend's ass.
They should.
Yeah, well, that's the way it goes.
Good point.
I'm just saying, if a woman is attracted to the feminine form, the guys that are sort of effeminate looking, sort of the David Bowies of the world, always get more tail than the Howie Longs of the world. Now, as a guy, you go, I'd blow that Howie Long 1,000 times over before I blew that fruitcake David Bowie.
Yeah,
but
right.
Chicks, they don't think that way.
Every guy says that.
That's what I say.
Yeah, of course.
That's what I say because I'm a man.
Mm.
You see that, Drew?
Mm.
I can blow Howie Long.
Taking notes.
Dan?
Yes. Hi.
You're 21?
Yep.
I don't know. Who was our last call? The big Buddha head guy?
I think it was sort of a bogus call. I really do. He's just calling to chat.
All right.
No, that's
got the Buddha head is a killer.
Yeah.
And that's bad. Certain cultures, Eskimos, Mexicans, who else got the Buddha head?
Alcohol gives you that.
Alcohol give you the Buddha head?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, give you like the big bloated head?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's bad times.
What's up, Dan?
Hi. I was wondering how long it takes for a girl, Dr. Drew, for a girl to, for her vagina to, like, open up, like, to loosen up.
Her vagina?
Vagina?
Yeah.
Well, you can loosen up faster, shove your banjo in there and auger it out.
No, well, my situation is I'm a little bit larger than my girl. Like, speaking of big guys, I'm, like, 6 foot, like, 230. She's, like, 5'2", like, maybe 110. And we've been having sex for, like, 3 weeks now, but she can't, like, we have to stop because she's in pain.
Yeah.
So, like,
that's not.
We love each other. We don't want to, like, you know, break up or anything, but.
I don't know. This sounds I'm not getting any feeling here either.
Yeah. Be that as it may. Is it a deep penetration she feels the pain, or just when you're starting
no,
out?
No, it's
or?
The width, like the bottom wall of her.
As it keeps going?
Yes.
Does she tear?
Going. Does she what?
Does she tear?
I don't think so. I don't know.
How about some lubrication?
No, she's fine on that.
No, but using some, just anyway, just to double down on that. That's something you can do. And this is something that sometimes is a
deal
breaker.
She lubricates is what you're saying, right?
Yeah, she's plenty fine on that.
Yeah. Yeah, hold on. Let me talk to my partner for a second.
Yeah, that's
how come every time you say, is your girlfriend lubricating normally? They go, oh, no, we don't use that stuff. Yeah. It gives us a rash. And then when I suggest, how about using some lubrication?
Yeah.
They seem to hear it as if.
Yeah,
they're lubricating.
I'm fine. She's fine on that. Oh, no problem there.
But what does that mean?
It means that she creates her own.
Right.
But that's not what we're saying.
Dan, does she?
Yep.
Dan, I say, how about some lubrication?
Using some lubrication.
I understand what you're saying.
And he's saying.
My response is that she is plenty fine on the canal. She is well lubricated, like dripping.
Right, but I'm.
All right, well, what he's saying
I'm
is...
I'm still saying, how about using some anyway?
Even so, use some anyway.
How would that change?
It sometimes helps.
As the Jews would say, it couldn't hoit.
Sometimes, although it may seem like there's plenty there, there may not be enough for what you guys are into here.
Well, if there's pain, I mean, it's almost... I mean, I'm not going to say impossible, but if there's tons of lubrication and there's pain, it just... It just means that there could be more lubrication 99%
that,
of the time.
Or it means that there really is a anatomic disproportion here, and this may be a deal breaker. I mean, some women actually tear down there where he's describing.
Yeah. She needs also, Dan, can she just get on top and get in a position where she gets to sort of control the tempo, the
she
depth, and the action?
More, like when she's on top. I don't know why, because I think her legs are spread more. Or
all right. Well, so you've tried different positions and nothing helps.
Well, the best position is missionary, like she says, for the least amount of pain.
All right. Well,
this is not a time issue. It's probably going to get worse with time, not better.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah.
Why?
Because it's
just more intense.
More irritating. It's going to keep getting worse.
Yeah.
Sometimes I've had relationship breakup over this. I've seen
you that. Have?
No, not personally.
Jeez, I wish I had. Bet you haven't, huh?
No.
Although Drew is, he's a well-endowed man of supreme passion, everybody. Yeah. All right. What'd you do on the 4th of July?
Went to a friend's house and watched the fireworks from the Rose Bowl.
Yeah, how was that?
It was good.
Mm.
And what'd you do?
I had a pool party at the party house.
Good times.
Yeah.
It's hot.
Yeah, it was hot. Played a little hoop, almost collapsed,
yeah.
And got my drunk on.
Uh-oh.
Got into some pie.
Oh,
okay. Somebody brought over a fresh peach. And, I mean, peach is great. You know, peach with the crust on top is great, but fresh peach with the whipped cream on top.
Ooh, wow.
You ever have that?
No.
Huh?
Yeah.
No?
No.
What? Why not?
I didn't know that existed.
You didn't know that existed?
Peach always had a crust on top.
No.
Or at least a little crisscross thing, no?
No. They have in-season peach.
Wow. I mean, like the strawberry kind of.
Yeah, like strawberries. Yeah. Just fresh, piled up, fresh-cut peaches in a glaze.
I guess you must have
some whipped cream on there. Yeah. Oh, yeah. That is solid. Yeah, I just ate like a madman. It was great. Went to a party at Jimmy's last night. He smoked ribs.
Mm.
Jimmy bought a new smoker.
Wow.
He's going nuts. Yeah, nothing better. You smoke the rib, then you put it on the barbecue. So it's barbecued and smoked.
How long do you leave it in the smoker?
I don't know.
It's like 3 days or something?
I think Jimmy got up at like 3 a.m. and fired up the smoker, but well worth it.
It's good.
Well worth it.
And associated with stomach cancer. It's all right. No big deal.
Oh, what, the smoking?
Yeah.
The barbecuing or the smoking things? But you can eat some smoked meat once in a while. Jimmy only eats it like four
days a week.
I was going to say 4 times a day. Wesley? Yeah, he smokes his Pez, smokes everything. Wesley, you're 17. What's up?
Well, I met this girl online. Her name's Melissa. We will not.
Don't believe it.
No, seriously.
Yeah.
We've been going out for 3 months. My mom, I told her about her. We've talked on the phone a lot. Tell my mom about all her problems, which includes several mental disorders. She seeks counseling regularly. She has some severe physical disabilities.
Calling all nerds. Severe physical disabilities?
She has spina bifida and scoliosis.
Hmm.
And why is that a severe?
Because by the time she's about 23, she's going to be in a wheelchair.
Does,
No.
That, what about spina bifida? Doesn't that have a kind of a wide range?
Yes, very wide range.
Well, how do we know that she's not on the more negative spectrum?
He would have said meningomyelocele or something like that.
Anyway. All right.
I told my mom about her problems, and
everyone has scoliosis.
That's right. That's right.
All right, go ahead.
Anyways, I told my mom about her problems, and my mom doesn't think that we should be together.
You met her on the internet?
Yeah.
How far away does she live?
I live in Texas, and she lives in Utah.
Well, that's why you shouldn't be with her. There you go.
Well, you're not with her. You can't be with her. You never were with her.
Well, she was going to come down for the summer. And,
No.
She's put a trailer hitch on the wheelchair?
Okay.
All right. Now, listen, Wesley.
Yeah.
Here's the deal. Hold on. Let me talk to Drew.
Talk about your Nate and his friend in Tennessee that he met on the web, or in Kentucky.
Listen, I was part of the Catholic Big Brother program. You know, unlike other B/C celebrities, I was a part of these charitable organizations before any of the celebrity crap came around. And then once I became a C celebrity, I washed my hands with all this nonsense. But I was part of the Catholic Big Brother organization. I would be part of the Atheist Big Brother organization, but those don't exist. And I figure Catholic was, I got suckered into it. Anyway, I had myself a Catholic little brother.
So to speak.
Oh, you know, I took my, you know, when I did the interview, they really try to weed out the pedophiles these days, you know. And they were asking me all kinds of questions, you know, how many times a day did I think about sex, and did I do drugs, and so on and so forth.
You answered honestly those things.
I did. Well, I don't know about the sex part. I told her 3 times a day. It just seemed about right.
How many times you jacked off?
I actually was probably beating off more like 7 or 8 times a day back then. But I thought that's what
she
meant when she was thinking about sex. That's what you mean, beating off,
it's
right?
Like one time, all day.
So So, but it was funny. Yeah, she said, you do drugs? And I was going to lie, and then I thought, oh, who cares? So they tossed me out. Big deal. So I said, I don't buy them, but if I'm at a party and something's going around, you know, count me in. And she was kind of all right with that. Her name was Lori. She was my counselor or something. Anyway, she hooked me up with Nate. I was hoping to get a black kid, you know, but I got a white kid.
Uh-huh.
But he was poor and screwed up, too.
But he had the Russian immigrant friend who thought he was a black kid.
Team, the Russian rapper. But anyway, what was I saying with Nate?
About his girlfriend.
Oh, yeah, he met a chick. He met a chick on the internet. And Nate had that calling all nerds kind of thing going for him, too. But he was good with the computer. Shocking. Poor mom, live in an apartment with like five of his sisters. Poor guy. He'd steal away, fire up the computer. Couldn't meet any chicks. So at his high school or anything. So he met this chick on the internet. Chick lived in Kentucky. He actually wanted to plan a summer road trip where I drove me and him to Kentucky in my beat-up Toyota, which I told him wasn't going to happen. But he used to call this girl all the time, and his mom finally canceled his phone privileges because he was running the bill up too much.
This was the days when long distance was expensive.
I guess it was,
$3 a minute, $4 a minute.
Yeah, and you get some horny 15-year-old teenager with his gal pal calling her trailer over there in Kentucky. You know what it is. When you're 15, you're on the phone. Next thing you know, it's 2.5 hours has gone by. You're still on the phone. His mom gets a bill for a couple $100, pulls the plug on his phone. So now he comes to his big brother, wants to make a phone. So I said, look, I'm going to give you my phone card. I was such an idiot. So I'm going to give you my phone card. You take my phone card, you go to the phone booth, you call your girl. But here's the thing. You're paying for it. He had like a summer job or something. I didn't have any money. He probably, you know, I probably made more money than he did marginally, but I had more overhead than him. I had a house in La Cañada, La Crescenta, with three idiot roommates. So, I had to pay for gas and stuff. So I said, look, you're paying me back. Whatever it is, if it's $2 in a month, it's $102, but whatever it is. But here's the deal. You can use the card. And this is why, by the way, you can't bargain with kids. You cannot bargain with them, especially horny teenage males. I said, I'm going to give you the card. Use it responsibly. Use it as long as you want. If you want to talk to her for 5-10 minutes a day and hang up, fine. At the end of the month, it'll be $30. No problem. You're working at the student store. It's all covered. But if you go nuts, I'm going to take it away. So just use it. Use it responsibly. Use it as long as you want. There's your privilege. Or go nuts and have your privilege taken away. I got my phone shut off about 10 days later. My phone got cut off at my house. And I was like, what the F's going on? And they're like, yeah, your phone card was at like $286 in like 4 days. So we cut your phone off. And I'm like, hello? How about a little phone call or heads up? They're like, yeah. We tried to call you, but we cut your phone off first. So I had to go down to the, Drew, you've never done this. You don't know the painful humiliation of the. There's that segment of society that has to pay their bills in person.
I've done that for city stuff in the past.
Been a part of that group for a long time. Where you actually go down to Van Nuys, stand in line with a bunch of people who are buying lottery tickets on welfare and slippers with their hair in curlers, like they're going somewhere after they pay the bill in person, and just write a cashier's check out every month for like $26 to keep their phone going. But yeah, there's a little indignity there. So you need to find a girlfriend who lives near you.
Yes,
when you're 15 years old.
The Utah to Texas connection ain't gonna make it.
It is a very easy
escape.
It's a very easy escape because everyone in your high school knows you as Johnny Nerdo, and everyone on the internet knows you as Rico Suave. So why not?
Right, but I don't care if she's a fighter pilot. There will be no relationship.
Okay,
all right.
We'll be back.
This is your radio. LoveLine will be right back.
As many as 1 in 3 Americans with HIV don't know it. To find a testing location near you, call toll-free 1-866-344-KNOW.
Yeah. It's LoveLine. I'm Adam. That's Dr. Drew. Phone number 1-800-LOVE-191. Gary Busey and Adam De La Pena will be in here tomorrow night. Gary's Gary's an old friend.
Uh-huh.
Known him for some time, and Adam De La Pena. is a dear friend of mine. He was a writer. He was my writing assistant over at the Man Show. Like
you need an assistant.
Season two. Yeah, you sitting down, Drew? Whoa. I don't type. Shocking.
I'm coming up with so many things we're learning tonight.
I know. I like the big jugs. Big I don't jug. Type. I claim these things make me more man.
Yeah, of course. You can claim all kinds of things. Go ahead. Next time. Yeah, okay.
Jimmy making fun of me for my meanwhile, he's on the Man Show and he types 70 words a minute. It's like a Jane Hathaway. It's like some kind of bank secretary. What kind of man knows? No man knows how to type. I'll tell you the kind of man I am. I stare at the computer keyboard and swear that someone has stolen the G. Like, where is it? I'm staring at it. It ain't here. I have to start dragging my finger up and down it to find it. Take me about 6 minutes to type my name on the computer. Yeah. That's the kind of man I am.
That's a good thing you have a $30,000 computer setup.
Yeah, it doesn't work. So here's the thing. Gary Busey and Adam De La Peña are going to be in here tomorrow night because they're with I'm With Busey, which is their new show, which is on Comedy Central.
It's going well.
Which is very funny. Yeah, it's going well. I've been watching it, so we'll talk to them tomorrow night. Chelsea?
Yeah?
You're 13?
Yeah.
What's up?
Well, see, a couple days ago, I caught my dad in the living room with his friend, and they were, like, kissing and stuff. And I don't know if I should tell my mom.
Like, fully making out?
What?
Yeah.
His male friend?
Yeah.
Ooh. I was projectile vomiting on my dad. Him and his male friend were just making out?
Yeah.
And they knew you were home?
Yeah, they thought I was sleeping.
Do gay guys even enjoy making out? I didn't even know. I thought no guys enjoyed that. Even, like gay guys would just be two guys, so there would be no making out. It would just be all,
all genital.
Handies and BJs. And,
I guess if there's a new relationship going.
All right. And did they see you?
Uh-uh. I just went back to my room. I was, like, really grossed out.
Is your dad a strange guy?
Yeah.
Why? What's he do?
He just acts weird sometimes.
Like what? Give us an example.
Like, he pretends. Like, he poses and stuff.
Poses?
Well, is he just sort of goofing around?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, at least he got a little sense of humor. You sure he wasn't just screwing with you, trying to freak you out or something? Maybe he knew you were watching?
I don't know.
Oh, okay, hold on. Her phone's so bad. Should she... Now, what if she said to her dad, hey, Dad,
yes,
I went in the living room, I saw you hugging that guy.
Yeah, what's going on?
What's up?
Yeah.
And...
If that, in fact, happened, he owes her a little explanation, sure.
Okay, but what if he doesn't give her an explanation that seems satisfying? Like, what if he says, like, hey, just mind your own business, sweetie. Then she should.
Yeah.
So you think... So she needs to say something to him.
Yeah. Do you have an older sibling?
Chelsea?
Yeah.
Older sibling?
No.
No.
No. Are you an only child?
Yeah.
Okay. No. What's your dad do for a living?
Nothing right now.
Nothing. What's your mom do? He's going to go what?
He's going to apply for a job tomorrow.
Doing what?
Working on cars.
No, he's not gay.
Yeah.
He's not gay unless he's, not gay. Not gay. Not gay guys don't work on cars.
I don't know.
he's a mechanic?
He does, like, paint cars.
Oh, and I was thinking, unless he does like some sort of thing with, convertible tops or maybe custom paint or something like it, possibly, like a pinstripe or something. But he just does, is he a fender guy,
He does body work too.
Does body work and paints cars, but he doesn't do custom paint, does he?
I don't know.
What's your mom do?
She does flagging.
Flogging?
Flagging.
Flagging. She works on road crews?
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh.
Yeah, we all know what flaggings are. Yeah, I have a long... the Corollas were all flaggers. We come from a long line of flagmen. My grandfather was a proud flagman. Well, he used to flag back in the horse and buggy days.
What?
Those things be coming up about 3-4 miles an hour. I need a guy out there. Now, he'd be wearing a bowler and a starch shirt and a tie with the orange flag.
And one of science says slow. Stop.
Slower. My God. This is what I want to do. This is the greatest gig in the world. This is a...
Flagger?
Yeah. Well, here's what it is. Chelsea?
Yeah?
Your mom's a flag. How long has she been flagging?
I think like a year.
How's their relationship, your dad and your mom?
It's pretty good, I guess.
Does your mom make pretty good money?
Yeah.
Yeah, because she works, like, for the city?
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. Talk to your dad. Tell him what you saw.
Yeah.
And just tell him you were confused by it.
Yeah.
You wanna know? Let me tell you something that goes on. This goddamn city. All these cities, but especially these, the Los Angeles. Los Angeles is so effed up. I got a buddy who's getting a job. When I used to do earthquake rehab work for the city, you wanted to be a laborer because a laborer got $21.50 an hour and the carpenters got like $18.50 an hour.
What?
It's effed up. I got a friend of mine right now. He's one of the guys I used to work with when I was doing earthquake rehab for the city. He just got in on a labor gig for the city, so he's getting $30 an hour now. It's so, first off,
$30 an hour.
Here's how the real world works. Carpenters get, yeah, somewhere between $15, $18, $25 an hour, depending on their skill level. And laborers get $8 an hour. Now, if you work for the city, the laborers will get $30 an hour and the carpenters will get $20. So you have guys that are experienced carpenters wanting to be laborers to get the extra money. It's just so, you wonder where all the goddamn tax money goes in this city? And here's what we do with these flaggers. We do these jobs. It's like, look, we need a certain amount of broads working on these jobs. Yeah, but women don't know anything about construction. Well, just put them in the orange flak jacket and have them hold the slow sign and drink coffee at the front of the thing and get $28 and full benefits for that. There we go. Now everyone's happy. Yeah, everyone's happy but me. I'm paying that bitch. Jesus Christ.
How much do you guys make an hour? I know the city doesn't pay for
fired
it.
Fired up. I'm just tired. I pay half my money to taxes, and all I can hear about it in Los Angeles, oh, the city's bankrupt, and we don't have enough money for anything, we can't afford anything, we got to get more money. You know, there's this whole car thing that's going, you know, they want to, I got like 8 cars, they want to like triple the car tax thing. Everyone says, we got to get more money from people who have money. How about stop giving the broads with the orange flak jackets $30 an hour? Jesus Christ. I don't know how do we waste all the money that comes in? And really, that's okay that there's some sort of bizarre alternate universe that the city runs off of that laborers get paid 10 times as much as the carpenters do. And when in real life in the private sector, labor was by definition just an unskilled set of hands and a back. They're lowest on the totem pole. They get $8-9 an hour if they're lucky. Jesus F, what's going on?
Well, that's wrong. Somebody should have to labor and study for 10 years so they can make less.
That's right, like that, Dr. Drew.
Yeah, of course.
Sons of bitches. Melissa?
Yes, hi.
Flagman.
What was that?
Go ahead.
Flagman.
Okay. I met my boyfriend a couple months ago.
Mm-hmm.
And then today he had called me to the bathroom and showed me a sore, like a pimple on his penis.
Mm-hmm.
And
I understand.
Like, pulled you into the bathroom.
What? Hey, look at this.
Yeah, he called me in there to look at it, and I asked him when he had gotten this, and he said that he noticed it a couple days ago, right after he had gotten back from the beach. And I asked him if he ever had anything, you know, previous to this, and he said that about 3 years ago, he went to the doctor, and he said that he had gonorrhea, and they gave him a pill, and said it would cure it up, and he hasn't had anything since then. Hmm. So I was wondering if it could be back, or if it could be a bite from something at the beach.
Melissa?
Yes?
Gonorrhea does not cause pimples.
Surfer girl could have bit him.
Well, I have no idea about any of it.
All right. Well, gonorrhea causes an infection in the tube he pees out of.
Right. He told me that it was burning and all that.
That's right.
3 years
no,
ago.
Gonorrhea does not cause any skin reaction at all.
Okay.
All right. Now, but guys can get pimples on their penises. They can get little carbuncles and things.
Yeah, he wouldn't pull her into the bathroom and show it to her,
well,
though.
He wouldn't have shown it if we were worried that it were an STD.
Well, I think he would have because better she see it this way than discover it.
Well,
exactly.
Was it ulcer or a pimple? Was it a whitehead? Is it a pus?
Yeah, it looks like a pimple, and he said that it itches like a bug bite, so I'm not...
Well, a bug bite is not a pimple.
Right, I know.
All right. Did the top look sort of clear and white, or was it just a red bump?
No, like a pimple.
White top.
The white head, yes.
White head.
And yeah, well, why didn't he pop it then if it had a white head on it?
Well, because I told him not to touch it.
Yeah, but he's been looking at it for a day and a half. Why isn't he?
Well, yeah, but I didn't want him to...
You don't want him to pop it or anything, but he's been looking at it for a day and a half without you knowing about it.
Is it? In other words, why didn't he spontaneously go after it himself?
She doesn't want him to do it.
Is it on the shaft?
Yeah, like maybe a half an inch or so down from the head. Yeah.
Oh, so about that. Three quarters of the way up.
Could be.
Okay, so Melissa. Thanks, bud. It could. So the worst thing it could be is herpes, right, Drew?
Yep. Painful ulcer.
He's never had a breakout.
But that doesn't cause whiteheads. It causes ulcers.
She doesn't know what she's talking about. How long have you been with him?
Since late January, so however many months that is.
Okay.
There's something called chancroid, too, but that usually doesn't get onto the penis. Has he not been traveling at all?
Traveling? No, just between L.A. and San Diego. That's about it.
All right. Well, he needs a doctor.
All right. Do you trust him? Do you think he's been screwing around on you?
I really don't think so.
All righty then. I really don't think so. Really? Okay, so he's a good guy?
As far as I know, yeah.
I mean,
she's been screwed over in the past with all that qualifier.
Has it? I mean, here's the thing.
He could be one of those guys.
I mean, look, we all know guys that, we know guys that can do this a lot more easily than other guys. I'm surprised the women don't.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, we know the guys. We know those guys who do that and those guys who don't do
that. Screw around you, man.
Yeah, or at least sort of have it. I mean, it's sort of like, you know, if you heard about a guy punching another guy or killing another guy or hurting another guy, and you place in one name and you go, yeah, if he had a couple beers, I guess the guy was getting on his nerves. And then there's another guy, you put his face in there and you go, no, impossible. Mm-hmm. Someone got the story wrong. He just wouldn't do that. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
You aren't you sort of aware of what people are kind of capable
same
of?
Same thing with cheating. It's exact same thing.
Yeah, like you just close your eyes. Like when the person goes, this person was, you know, screwing a secretary at work. Close your eyes, put the right name in there, right face in there, and you go, yep. Put the wrong one in, you go, no. And then once in a great while, you get blown away and completely can't believe it. You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
Like the neighbors when the guy was putting bodies under his house. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Except not us.
No. All right, we'll take a quick break.
I mean, nothing ever surprises. No one ever surprises us. You know what I mean?
Once in a while, I hear something juicy that's good. But you're right. We'll take a quick break. We'll be right back. Did you fart?
No.
You sure?
But I do have to pee, so let's go.
All right.
LoveLine will be right back.
LoveLine. 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 LoveLine.
Love Line. With Adam Carolla and Dr. Drew. Call Loveline at 1-800-LOVE-191. Live 105. Alternative. San Francisco.
Hey, everybody. It's Loveline. I'm Adam. That's Dr. Drew. Phone number 1-800-LOVE-191. Gary Busey, the great actor, along with funny writer. And now a celebrity in his own right, Adam De La Pena, is going to be in here from I'm with Busey. They're going to be in here tomorrow night. 311 is going to be in here on Tuesday night. Les and Jake is going to be in here on Wednesday night. All right. Let's get back to the phones, Drew.
Yeah.
We got to help them kids.
All right.
Let's talk to Phil. Phil's 23. Phil?
How you guys doing?
Good.
All right. Well, basically, my question's for Drew. Uh-huh. I know that you're an addiction specialist, and I have an ex-girlfriend/girlfriend that's currently serving a term in prison, and she's due to be released in September, and she wants to give it another go after a 2.5-year breakup, basically.
She's been in jail 2.5 years?
Off and on. She's currently doing an 11-month stint in the prison.
Yep.
Just finally finishing up her bad history or whatever, but the reason why we broke up in the first place was her drug use, you know, methamphetamines or whatever, and I don't do drugs. The worst I've done is maybe smoke some pot or drink beers, you know.
Okay.
Hey. And I hate when people say that's the worst they've done. To me, that's the best. Yeah, a little weed, a little brewski. It's not the worst, buddy. All right, but Phil, what's gone wrong with your life? Not the drug part, but what's gone wrong with your life? You're 23. You've been with this sort of junkie chick. She's in and out of the joint. You're waiting around for her. What's going on?
Well, I wanted to ask Drew, basically, if I do give her another shot at it, what should I be in store for? What should I be expecting, you know, with her addiction? Because I know that it's going to be a problem for her, something she's going to have to deal with.
Go ahead and answer Adam's question first, because that actually is pertinent.
Thank you.
Well, sorry, Adam. That's why I was calling, though.
Okay.
Well, but, listen, come on. What you can expect out of her is more the same unless she's unless kicked she's, her addiction.
Unless she is actively involved in treatment on a daily basis.
Yeah. And then she shouldn't be with you then in that case, I mean, for a while.
Well, the reality is that's absolutely right. Unless you are actively engaged in a recovery, codependency recovery program, you will keep her sick. And I know you don't understand how that works, but if you go to Al-Anon, get a sponsor, work steps, and she is actively engaged in a program, there's a possibility of both of you getting better and her staying clean. Uh-huh. Without that, essentially zero probability.
But what's gone wrong with your life, back to my question, that you're still hanging around?
Well, I wasn't. I mean, I just got contacted back in November. You know, I had finally gotten over the pain and hurt of the whole thing and moved on a little bit, gotten over the depression of the whole thing.
And you got contacted in November.
And you're hanging around since.
Yeah, I got contacted and she got, you know, she's locked up, so she's clean. And that makes me, you know, happy because I've known her for
all right, but that's good. But what do you do for a living?
Well,
right now,
a little of this, a little of that, yeah. Construction. No, not construction.
Oh, not construction. Here's what's going on. Here's what I'm hearing, Phil. Your life is not moving ahead like it should. So you're hanging out behind waiting for someone to get out of prison to warm over an old bad relationship. Whereas if you were moving ahead with your life, your career and other matters like that, you wouldn't be looking back. You'd be wishing her well and everything. You want her to get sober and stay sober, but you'd be well ahead by now. Something's going on where you're kind of stalled out.
Oh, well, I don't know about that.
All right. You're doing great, buddy. What's that mean? What are you doing?
Well, my question was for Drew. Do you want to know about me? Or
yes.
Yes.
Do you want to know about me? I repossess cars. I'm a locksmith.
Okay.
Okay. My parents... they were addicted to cocaine in the 80s, and it broke their marriage up.
All right, well, that's why you've now sought in your life another drug addict. And unless you get some treatment for your codependency, you will keep her a drug addict. And you will continue to seek people who have disorders that you can take care of. So really, all that matters is about you, Phil. So Adam's question was quite pertinent.
Thank you, Drew.
The only thing that matters...
total vindication. Thank you,
is you,
Dr. Drew.
And... the reality is that she may or may not get better. If she does and you're getting better, then fine. Then maybe there's a relationship there. Otherwise, you're both going to keep yourself stuck in this quagmire you're in right now.
Well, the reason I was pressing Phil is I was getting I think that Phil liked the idea of having a project.
Yeah.
Like the spotlight would never be on him and what's not working in his life.
That's
because
right.
There was always somebody to put back together who was in worse shape than he was.
And there's various sort of variations on that theme, but that's basically right. And the bottom line is that you were traumatized by these addicted parents, and now you're going to make it right in your adult life, and you're attracted to these people that sort of make you feel the same pain you tuned into in your parents that you couldn't control and felt powerless over. Now you're going to fix that in your adult life, and it doesn't work like that. You end up just being in a relationship with another drug addict.
Yeah, but a repo guy.
Yeah.
There's a great gig.
Quaint.
You know, it's funny. They just let this guy, the bounty hunter that got the Max Factor niece or son or heir or whatever. Anyway, the Mexican authorities just let him go, I think, a couple of days ago. But the thing that's funny is because bounty hunting is illegal in Mexico,
right?
Which I find interesting because, first off, it's the first thing I've ever heard that was illegal in Mexico. Like, here's what you can do in Mexico. You go to the pharmacy, buy roofies and quaaludes, duct tape them to an M80 that you buy in the next corner, just swig off a bottle of tequila and fire them from a wrist rocket at school kids. They're trying to sell chiclets. That's all legal, but try to haul in a rapist. That's where they got to draw the line. I think they call it overcompensation. I'm not sure, but that's the one thing that's illegal?
Bad PR.
Tracking rapists? They got to get it. You're right. Mexico needs a publicist, Drew. Alan?
Hey, how you doing? What's up, Ace? What's up, Dr. Drew?
Good times. But the guy's great, though. He looks like a wrestler.
Yeah, I like Drew sticking up for his buddy Adam.
Yeah.
Hey, I've been listening since the first year, and I was wondering, that would be cool to get, Ricky Rackman and Poor Man on the show, so you could have, the whole Loveline history in, one show.
Yeah, no. That'd be interesting. Well, Ricky's been on the show.
As a guest, yeah.
As a guest, I think.
Oh, really?
Yeah, Poor Man, I think there's some litigation that's still pending or something like that.
Or that the current company wouldn't allow because of the litigation.
Yeah.
Well, anyways, I had two questions, but when I was on hold, I realized that my second question was more important, so I'm going to go for that.
Mm.
I've been getting these weird sleep disturbances. Two things happen. It's actually been happening on and off for years.
You wake up frozen, you can't move?
Well, it's almost like that happens. I don't wake up. It's like before I go to sleep that happens.
Yeah, but you're frozen. You can't move. You're sort of awake, but you feel like you can't move any muscle in your body.
Yeah, we had it, and it also feels like my body's kind of expanding, and if I don't wake up, I'm going to explode. Mm. That sounds weird, but it feels like that.
Yeah.
I feel a pressure in my chest and a pressure in my head.
Yeah.
That's one sleep disturbance. The other one I have is I just stop breathing.
Yeah. Okay. Hold on.
Yeah. I'll tell him what to do.
I wake myself up, but when I wake up, I'm not like gasping.
Well, that's sleep apnea, right?
These are sleep disorders of various type, and they do tend to go together.
What should he do?
Do
I ask him?
Are you a heavy guy?
You a big guy?
No, I'm actually in shape.
Worse. Because now you can't lose weight.
But what weirds me out is what I've read about sleep apnea, it's almost like the guy doesn't know it. Maybe his partner knows
it. Yeah, this is a little different kind of a sleep disturbance.
And it
can be associated with other conditions. You do need to have a pretty thorough medical evaluation.
So
to make
you
sure
go
that
to a sleep specialist, right?
Yeah, or any cardiologist or pulmonologist actually should be able to do the workup for this.
Well, so where should he start?
I would start with a sleep pulmonologist if you can get that. It may end up being nothing, in fact, but it is something that does need to be completely evaluated.
Yeah, it could be dangerous.
Yeah.
All right, take care.
Here it is. Bottom line, it sucks being single today. Tons of lame people and no decent prospects. Call the Dateline. Call the Dateline. Call the Dateline.
1-877-889-DATE.
Loveline!
Loveline will be right back. So get your problems ready. Ready. Ready.
Yeah, Drew's favorite song.
Oh, yeah. You got to bring that tape in. I was looking for it myself this weekend.
Oh, Drew, Dr. Rapping. Drew on Crank Yankers rapping. I don't know if I have that tape.
I don't know either.
It's going to air. I don't know.
It aired already.
Oh, it did?
It was on like 3 months ago.
It was on 3 months ago?
Give it to me.
When is it? I don't have the tape. I could probably find it.
You said that every night we brought this up.
Well, because it would involve me making a phone call. And you know how difficult that is, Drew. Mm. Right, we're going to get that. Somebody TiVo it. Do something. All right, what's the phone number here, Drew?
800-LOVE-191.
That's right.
And somebody do something.
Gary Busey in here tomorrow night with Adam De La Pena, also from Crank Yankers and The Man Show. We will go to the phones, speak to Mandy, who's 25. Mandy?
Hi.
What's up?
Okay, I saw some discoloration on my breast today, and I'm worried about it.
Did you, like you bruised yourself? What are you talking about?
I didn't, it looks like a bruise. It looks blue.
Maybe you did bruise yourself.
But I didn't bump it. I didn't do anything to it, and all of a sudden, like I took a shower, I came out of the shower, and it was there.
Does it look like a vein? Like a vein
maybe,
you can sort of see?
Yeah, kind of bluish purple, and after I saw it, then I felt my breast hurting. So I don't know, is it psychosomatic or...
You take a lot of aspirin or anti-inflammatories, Motrin, that sort of thing?
No, not usually.
Have you been lately?
No.
Are you on any medication?
Just birth control.
Anything new that way?
No new medication. I have been doing the tanning bed.
Nah.
Would that do it?
No.
How do you like that tanning bed?
How do I like it?
Yeah.
Good.
You go naked?
Yeah.
I like the tan lines. You should put the bikini on.
No, not so much.
Yeah, not for you, but for me, yes. I mean, who are you doing it for?
Okay, well, maybe if we ever go out, then we'll have to look into that.
Yeah, but the point is it might be too late by then.
You know what I'm saying? You need just the bottom on or the whole thing?
I like the bottom and the top.
Yeah. Well, Dr. Drew, is this something I should just go to the doctor about?
Yes, it is, but it's certainly nothing you need to be worried about.
It's not some type of tumor or vein or anything?
No.
I don't like a thong back line either. I like just, regular, but hike them up a little bit.
Okay, good.
You know what I mean?
But, Mandy, this do you tend to obsess about your stuff a lot, or is this just something tonight freaked you out?
You know what? It just happened all of a sudden, and why would my breast be blue?
Well, you can get spontaneous bruising anywhere. You're a heroin addict. No.
Drew, please.
And it doesn't necessarily mean anything.
Sounds like a delight, though.
And it is something, again, if there's multiple bruises in the various parts of your body, that's something to definitely look into. But a bruise, tap, maybe a vein that comes to the surface. Can there going to be, are you coming up on your period?
No, I just finished, actually.
Okay.
Oh, I'd love to talk to her when she's on her period. Can I ask
Yes, go right ahead. I want to hear it.
Go ahead, honey. Ask away.
I want to talk to her.
I'm not stopping her from asking.
You're stopping her from
hearing. Well, we didn't say we're going to answer. Just ask it. Just ask. Jamie?
Yeah?
What's up? You're 17.
I dated this guy for 2 years, and we broke up, and the breakup was, it wasn't really bad, but he didn't necessarily want it. And we tried to be friends for a little while, but it ended up, we fought all the time, and it just didn't work out the way we wanted it to. So we stopped talking, and this was about 6 months ago. And just recently, we started talking again, and he came over to my house, and one thing led to another, and we ended up sleeping together again.
Yeah.
And before, the first time...
Can I stop you for a second?
Uh-huh.
The whole one thing led to another thing is not ever a male perspective statement. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Guys, one things do not lead to another. Guy goes up with the intent to and carries out his mission.
Yeah.
It's not one thing leads to
part
another.
He's a one-man SEAL team.
Yes.
He comes over on a Zodiac boat. He rolls off the edge.
It's like the bridge in the river quiet. One thing led to another and the bridge came down. It's like, no.
But here, I'll tell you, the only time a guy uses the one thing led to another is when he's
trying to get out of
got busted.
Yeah.
Screwing his friend's girlfriend.
Yeah.
Hey, bro, we just drink some wine coolers. We're both watching Smoking the Bandit, and the next thing you know,
it's not even one thing or another. It's the next thing you know.
Yeah,
it's like pow, whoa!
But
it's dropped in from the sky.
Yeah, but even that's BS.
Of course, but one thing led to another.
It's the only time the guy will play that one thing led to another card.
But it's first thing you know.
I understand that, but then then he spent the night at my house the next 3 nights, and we didn't do anything at all. Like, it was just like old times when we used to go out and just snuggle in my bed. It was just, we didn't even do anything those nights.
All right, well, how old is he?
He's 20.
I don't know. Maybe I'm old-fashioned or something. It's just weird 20-year-old guys, like, snuggling with 17-year-olds. That just seems, I know it's only 3 years, but it's kind of creepy.
How long did you date him for?
For 2 years.
2 years, and that was when he was in high school, too?
Yeah.
And no.
But you were like, what, you were 15, 14 years old?
Yeah,
and he was like 17?
Yeah.
18?
Ooh.
It's a little weird. Now, it was your idea to break up?
Yeah, it was my idea.
Why?
Because he was smoking a lot of pot, and like he stopped for me for a long time, and he didn't
This is why he can snuggle for a few days. No drive. It just
smoked a lot of weed, yeah. Pot.
So that's where that comes from.
Yeah, he wasn't snuggling. He was just passed out. His arm was on top of you.
Yeah.
Okay, look, I think you had the right instincts to dump the guy in the first place.
Yeah.
Why don't you sort of stick to that?
It's really easy to fall back in old patterns in a relationship, particularly at your age. It's so close when you're in your teens. You're so enmeshed in those relationships, and they just sort of slide right back in again. You need to start to set some boundaries and set up a sense of yourself with someone who's more mature and available,
but
in a more meaningful way.
You got sort of plans for your life, and he doesn't really have plans for his life?
Yeah, basically.
All right.
Yeah.
This is what happens. You go off to college. He goes off to junior college, which I know has the word college in it, but it's a totally different thing.
Where are you going to school? College. Where do you want to go?
I want to go to Virginia Tech.
All right.
All right, that'll it. You'll meet some guy over there who'll be on like the crew team or something, and you'll do what my ex-girlfriends do, where they actually shudder, they cringe.
When
they used to do this, I mean, they don't do it anymore.
They cringe thinking
celebrity, but back like when my ex-girlfriends would think about me, they'd be like, ugh.
Like, you dated that one? Yeah. Oh.
Yeah, it was weird. I
can't believe it. Oh,
yeah. It was like it was like when people tell some story where they go like
trauma.
I was eating I was at a chili cook-off, and a potato bug had fallen into the chili, and I just ate the entire It's that same feeling. Drew, what happened to potato bugs? They used to be more popular.
Yeah.
You know what the potato bug looks like?
What?
We haven't talked about the potato bug in a while.
Looks like it's got big teeth, big chomper.
Big bulgy eyes.
Yeah, it's
big
horrible.
Big round, bulbous head.
Yeah.
I don't know what else they call them. The world's fattest bug.
I think they only exist out here in the West somewhere. But I'll tell you, potato bug story. I was 17 and was a girlfriend watching a movie.
Yeah.
What was that Gregory Peck movie with the alien,
Omen?
Damien,
yeah.
And we're walking down the street in Westwood, California. And all of a sudden she goes, what? Starts stamping her foot. Potato bug falls out of the pant leg.
Really?
Yeah.
True.
How wild is that?
And you were like finger banging her 10 minutes earlier, right? That's just the end of your pinky. It broke off in her.
They're called Jerusalem crickets.
Yeah.
Is that right?
Jerusalem crickets. They must be around
How
other
did you know that?
Places, right?
Because I was so scared of them. I looked them up. I spent like an hour on the internet.
They're the most terrifying bug ever. Yeah.
Found one in the pool over the weekend.
How weird is that?
This last weekend?
Yeah, like yesterday.
Okay, we've never spoken of these things.
Like, we spoke about the potato bug like 5 years ago.
Yeah, my old girlfriend found one in her house, and like she put a book on top of it, and the book started moving. It was
They're crazy. Like, they're the only insects that seem like vermin. Like, you see, like, leaves rustling and stuff, and you think there must be a big rat or raccoon or something under there. It's an actual bug. It's an insect. All right.
And they're always by themselves. There's like one in like 100 miles, square mile.
Yeah, they patrol a large area. They're lone wolves. They fly solo, those potato bugs. Yeah, you never see a line of potato bugs going to the potato bug hole. They're not social creatures. All right. We got
to
look those
up. Tell me things we have to bring up tonight that we haven't brought up in 100 years that everyone has had experience with during the day-to-day.
Yeah, I'm not quite sure how that energy works. I'm not a real cosmic guy, but it is funny that Drew was talking about the band Rush today, and I made some sort of Rush reference at the beginning of the show, which I never make, and Drew never talks about Rush, and we've never had a conversation about Rush.
And you were talking about Rush and drugs, and I was talking about Rush and who wasn't doing drugs on Rush.
What? Oh, you mean you're having a conversation? Yeah. Oh, okay. Someone used to do drugs. Yeah. All right. And then potato bug. Anderson saw a potato bug in a pool today. I don't think I've seen a potato bug since I was 9. Mm. I thought you were legally not allowed to spot potato bugs after you. It's like once you get higher than 3.5 feet tall, you don't see them anymore. Like I have not seen one since I was 9 years old.
Is it Jerusalem beetle or Jerusalem cricket?
Cricket.
Beetle.
Cricket.
Okay.
That's why Jerusalem wants.
I'm just trying to get it down.
I know, but you said. He said, is it beetle or cricket? And Anderson put the thumb up, which would be for the last one, right? Yes, sir. Lindsay?
Yes.
Smart one. You're 15. What's up?
My dad, verbally abuses me and my sister.
What's he say?
He just yells and...
Shut up, damn it!
Mm-hmm. Is he drunk?
No, surprisingly, he's supposedly a Christian. And
where's your mom?
She died when I was 9.
Oh, my God. What'd she die of?
Huh?
What'd she die of?
Suicide.
Oh. How'd she do it?
She took 32 methadone.
Right. Was she a methadone addict?
No, she took it for painkillers.
She's a methadone addict.
32, that'll kill you, Andrew.
Is your dad doing pain pills, too?
No, all the crap that he does to me and my sister is because his new wife that he got married to in November tells him to do all this stuff to us, and he does it.
His wife tells him to yell at you?
Yeah.
For no reason?
Well, they find the stupidest stuff to yell at us about.
Give us an example.
Birth control.
What?
Birth control?
Oh, birth control.
That you should be on it or you shouldn't be on it or what?
He yells at us about being on it and then eating in our rooms, and this is stuff that he never used to care about.
Well,
he wasn't much of a parent before.
But when you were 9, he didn't care about birth control or?
No.
It sounds like you're sort of kicking into gear and trying to be a parent.
The last 7 months since he got married, everything has changed. He's completely turned on us.
Maybe he hasn't turned on you. Maybe he's just trying to set limits for you and just not very good at doing that.
What about birth control? You guys are on birth control?
Yeah, we're both on it, and we just found out that my dad's wife's on it.
He's what?
What wife's on it?
Why are you guys on birth control?
I take it because I don't want my period. My sister's, she has a boyfriend. And
how old's your sister?
She's almost 18.
Okay, so it's good to be responsible. That's good.
But can you, I don't want to give you tough love, but compose yourself a little bit, Lindsay. You don't have to cry. We can talk about this.
I'm afraid that my sister's in her room right now dead, and I don't know what to do.
You're afraid she's in there dead?
I'm afraid she's going to kill herself.
What?
Well, did she say she was going to do that?
We're not stable.
Why aren't you stable?
I don't know.
Sounds like a trick question.
Depression.
But you're depressed.
And you're under treatment for that?
Not right now. My sister's on. She's taking stuff for it, but I'm not because my dad won't take me to get anything.
Why don't you call the doctor who's treating her and notify them about your concerns, okay? And if you don't do that, you got to call a local police department.
Yeah.
You got to say, if this is a really an issue of life or death, you have to do that. You have to do that.
Why are you taking birth control to stop your period?
Because I'm on the depot, so it
stops your period.
I have really bad periods and painful.
So. Depot can make you more depressed, too, so be careful with that. All right?
All right. And what's your dad do for a living?
He works at a bank.
Aha. The man, I knew it. Hey, listen, Lindsay.
Yeah.
Let me just say this. My sister hated my stepmother too. My sister hated everybody when she was 15. Your dad, him being verbally abusive is not right. Him wanting you to not eat in your room and to sort of lay some ground rules down and probably trying to reset up house
is good.
That's really a decent instinct to try to create some stability and some structure. I know it's not sitting well with you, and it's tough compared, you know, especially losing your mom when you were 9 and all that kind of stuff. But, and it's going to be a tough sell with stepmom and all that. But is there a way you can sort of look at this as him caring, him wanting to have some structure and create a
think how much more easy it is for him just to do nothing and let things hang loose. That's easy.
It's absolutely any parent, the opposite, actually. He's trying to do everything in his power to get us out or dead.
Dead?
No.
Why wouldn't he kill you if he wanted you dead?
He doesn't love us anymore, and I know that sounds hard to say, but it's absolutely true.
Well, yeah, but he never said that.
Yes, he does.
That's just the way you feel.
He says all the time, I don't love you anymore?
Yeah.
No. No.
He doesn't want us with him anymore.
No, but he does. You're fabricating a lot of things here, Lindsay. Even this business about him not loving you. That's he doesn't say that.
All right. Yeah. All right. Listen, my headphones are.
But she's had to deal with a methadone addicted mom who committed suicide.
Yes.
And a dad who is a little chaotic and doesn't know how to express himself in a way that's firm and caretaking.
Yes.
And he's making her feel like crap.
Yeah. And listen, I'm just telling you from my own experience, 15-year-old chick, here's the thing. She would hate her mom if her mom was still alive. And now that her mom's gone, she's going to hate her stepmom.
Mm-hmm.
Stepmom's going to hate her.
Mm-hmm.
My sister, my stepmom went at it all the time. Because stepmom's feeling is like, hey, I just came in here. Why are you shooting me so much tood, honey?
Mm-hmm.
And stepmom will try to be nice for about 10 minutes, just on behalf of the whole new whatever. And then they go, look, F it. Screw you. I got no stake in this. It's a horrible situation. Women, when they hit age 14 and a half, should all just be taken off to some sort of camp in the Swiss Alps and raised until they're in their 30s, and then they can be released back onto the public. They hate each other. They hate their moms. They hate their stepmoms. They hate everybody. Here's who my sister hated. My sister hated my dad, my stepmom, my mom, and my stepdad.
And the rest of humanity.
She hated everyone. Man, I was like, I'm going to eat some yogurt and play football. I'll be back in about 3 days. My sisters hate everybody.
Whoa.
But look, you can't, especially if you kick them around like this. You can't have crazy methadone mom.
Let me talk to Lindsay off the air. Keep her on hold there.
Yeah, this is...
That's good times, huh?
You see, that's why you got to have sons. Sons, you know what sons do? They just go get into fights, you know? Maybe they cut on themselves a little bit. Maybe they go a little goth. It's cool. Ball guy. Drew, where are we going now with these calls? You got something picked out?
I think we
got
to go to break so I can deal with Lindsay, huh?
Really?
Yeah. A little early now.
All right.
Anderson, all right with that?
Yeah. I got some great pictures of potato bugs.
Got some potato bug pictures you can go look at. All right. We'll be back.
Love Line.
We'll be right back. LoveLine is brought to you by Trojan, America's number one condom, the most trusted for over 80 years.
Hey, everybody. LoveLine, I'm Adam. That's true. Gary Busey in here tomorrow. Veteran of over 100 films.
Really? 100 films? Wow.
Yep. Adam De La Pena in here tomorrow. Veteran over 1 million burritos. That's some good. Good Mexican humor, huh? He's good people. He was my writer's assistant over at The Man Show, and then a full-fledged writer. Showed up. We hired him because he showed up in a Hawaiian shirt that he made.
Wow.
Yeah. This is Adam De La Pena coming in tomorrow night from I'm with Busey. I wore over the weekend the shirt he sewed me.
Wow.
So Jimmy and I shirt. Yeah. I like a guy who shows up for a job interview wearing a Hawaiian shirt. Not only a Hawaiian shirt, but one of those orange long sleeve cotton surf shirts underneath it. You know, that's just, imagine that. Not really. It's crazy. Look, hair all over the place. Doesn't have a driver's license. Likes magic.
Okay, so those of you that are trying to figure out how to ace a job interview.
Yeah.
Forget it.
Listen, be yourself. You got to stand out.
Be yourself stuff.
We hired another guy because he said he was good at softball. Turned out he was horrible. He's a horrible writer. He's horrible at softball, too.
But learn you.
Yeah, you got to make an impression. And this guy beat out guys that went to, Harvard and Yale and stuff. It didn't really. Yeah, all right.
It proves you guys are horrible employers. Come on.
Right. That's right. We're talking about softball. John?
Yeah.
You're 25. What's up?
Hey, I just want to say, Dr. Drew, I definitely envy you and,
envy.
Yeah, no, I look up to you and, but what really scares me is, I agree with what Adam has to say sometimes, but anyways, on to my question. I smoke pot every day, and I get along with my job fine, no big deal, but, I kind of want to slow down and not have to, smoke before I have to go in because I can't eat in the morning without smoking.
What kind of work do you do?
I'm in grocery business.
Drives a school bus.
Airline pilot.
No driving, no nothing like that. I had to pass a drug test to actually get the job, but...
Yeah? How'd you do that?
You guys want to know, huh?
Yeah. I do.
Got a fake pass.
I smuggled some urine in.
Yeah.
Right. That's good. You know you've arrived when you're smuggling urine into places.
You're not addicted, though. No way. No.
Well, it's something you get through high times. It's called a Wizinator.
That's the fake penis?
Yeah, exactly. Prostate gland.
Fake penis. No, not addict. No, do not accuse.
I love it.
What's that laugh?
Wow, that is a great pot laugh. And listen, by the way, you would not be fooling Dr. Drew if he was working over there with that crazy pot laugh.
Oh, not at all.
All right, so.
I'm going to quit smoking or anything.
Why can't you eat unless you're stoned?
Well, it's not that I'm stoned. It's not that I actually have to get stoned. It's just that my stomach feels like.
The reason is he has to dose up about every 12 hours or he'll get withdrawal. And one of the symptoms of withdrawal
You'll get withdrawal?
Yeah. Well, it's not, withdrawal is even nausea, anorexia, agitation, irritability.
It's like nauseated. You know
yeah,
what I mean?
And that's exactly. That's marijuana withdrawal. So when he doses back up again, he's okay.
So it's like one minute he doesn't want to eat, the next minute he wants to eat 26 bowls of Captain Crunch. Yes.
Not necessarily, just regularly. You know what I mean? I'm over the munchies. It's just like
no, but this is worse than the munchies. you're having withdrawal.
Tape his laugh, please. The ultimate pot laugh.
No, we enjoy it. But, hey, John, this means it's time to stop.
There's no cutting down at this stage.
Absolutely. Like Drew said, I'm not going to – I can absolutely function. You know what I mean? It's not like I can drive.
But the point is you're having withdrawal in the morning.
And so there's
no cutting down. You have to detox. It takes about 2 weeks at this level. And it's a pretty miserable detox no sleep for up to a month easily.
Oh, really?
And, oh, yeah. It's an opiate detox, basically.
Well, but he segues on to the booze.
Yeah. Well, that's the way people do it sometimes. Usually they segue over to speed or heroin, frankly.
Here's the whole thing about pot, about booze, about all drugs, really. If you sort of think about it, I'm just having this thought. But human beings are pretty adaptable and fairly amazing. I mean, you can have not slept for 26 hours, have a couple of sleeping pills in you and a couple of highballs, and I could run into you at the airport and you wouldn't know that I was in that state.
I wouldn't?
No, you wouldn't. You wouldn't. You've seen me. You've
yeah,
seen
yeah.
me jacked right. out of my mind.
Right. I didn't maintain. Know it?
No, you didn't know it. How dare you?
I know it right away.
All right, so you smell some beef eater and some gas, but it doesn't mean you would know it. You wouldn't know it from my actions or demeanor.
Yes.
Ooh, speaking of beef eater, Drew, don't let anything fly too. Drew said he had gas, and I don't want to tempt his ass. I'm sorry. Here's what I'm saying.
Apologizing.
Sorry, man. That was my ass. That wasn't me. Here's all I want to say.
Yeah.
These people who say, hey, man, I get stoned every day, or I have a couple of pops, or I have a couple of lines, I go to work. Hey, I function fine. I do my job fine.
That doesn't mean anything.
Well, here's the deal. Yeah, you can. You can be about 80%.
For a while.
The whole world can be about 80%. Now, if you want to do anything in life, you got to get that other 20% in. That's the problem. I mean, you can get up in the morning, show up at your menial job, make your paycheck, not get fired, and go back home to your crappy apartment and smoke more weed, and you can do that for 100 years.
Well, no, you can't.
Okay, but here's my point. Everyone wants to talk about how they function and that they can function.
Yeah.
Of course you can function. Yeah. You don't thrive, you function.
I have heroin addicts that function for years before the progressive nature of the disease comes to bear.
Yeah, and you
it's
don't...
It's a progressive illness, and it progresses at different rates in different people in different circumstances. It may take 10 years to progress, may take 10 weeks. Different for different people. It always progresses.
I know. And I know that's your angle. And my angle is one we don't really bring up much.
If you want to have a life.
People are sort of proud that they're sort of, they sort of say with pride, hey, man, I have a bong low when I wake up. But you know what? I go to work. Boss doesn't know it. Yeah, boss doesn't know it. He hasn't given you a raise in 3 years. But he doesn't know you're stoned. He just thinks you're stupid. You know, you just end up sort of flatlining and you don't remember the last 5 years. But you're not getting fired. And you're not in jail, and you're paying your taxes. But if that's enough, then so be it. And then you do hit the wall at some point. All right. I got to get drunk in about half an hour, by the way. It reminded me. Are you ready to go?
Mm.
Taylor?
Hello.
You're 24?
Yeah.
You sound hot.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Yeah, I have a chlamydia question.
Oh, man. Why are you doing this?
I know. I screwed you up, huh?
Yeah.
I think it was like 3 months ago, I was at my, you know, pap smear, and they do the routine chlamydia test, and it came back positive. And
you had the urine test or a smear, or what'd they do?
They did the smear, and then they did, I think they stuck something up there. I think, yeah. And it came back positive, and they gave me the one-day dose.
Right.
And they say, come back in 6 weeks, and I did, and I confronted my boyfriend, and he went to his doctor, and it came back negative.
Hmm.
And he's the only one I've ever been with.
Hmm.
So I'm wondering what, and then I go back 6 weeks later for a checkup. It's still positive.
Hmm.
Keep in mind, I hadn't had sex in like 6 weeks with my boyfriend.
Mm-hmm.
And so I'm like, what's the possibility of a missed test or?
There's something wrong with the test. There's something going on here. Something's
my
Yeah, so something is wrong.
I'm going back on Saturday to finally, you know, we're both going. Because he went to his doctor and I went to, you know, a clinic because I don't have health insurance.
Yeah.
So I'm like, I'm really, like, you know, weirded out.
Sound like a smoke detector.
Yeah.
That's my cell phone. It's dying.
No. Okay, all right.
Not a smoke detector voice.
I don't hear any junior college in your voice, by the way.
No. I'm college educated.
Yeah, four year, right?
Uh-huh, yeah, I just graduated.
From where?
Cal State LA.
Right, no junior college?
No.
Yeah, don't hear it any.
Thank you, I think that it's a
college. Yeah, don't
but
hear
then it. But, you know, they may want to do something a little more thorough. They probably did one of these immunofluorescent tests, and they're pretty accurate, but sounds like something is wrong with this testing. Particularly since it didn't go negative after you were treated properly without any further sexual contact. So you need to give all that history to your doctor and let him or her sort of begin sorting this out more thoroughly. Certainly treating both of you again would be a reasonable thing to do just for safety's sake, but trying to understand what has gone on here, yeah. Probably a false positive.
Yeah. One day I'm going to sit down and I'm going to put together the Corolla collective years of junior college, not me, the family.
Is there any? Anybody at college? Oh, what?
Junior college. Junior college. Yeah. I know my mom's got... Mom could have
That's four, adult
my mom
college.
Could have 14 years of junior
Whoa.
College. Yeah. I mean, spread out over, you know, maybe 22 years, but...
Wow.
Say, it could be good. Could be 14 years.
Huh.
14 years. Yeah. I know my grandmother has a few years. I know my dad must
well, your
dad
mom must was
have
able
five,
to
six
take
years.
All that education and move it into quite an active...
Yeah,
career path.
She was after 13 years at junior college, she was able to get into the prestigious Cal State Northridge, and then go ahead with the Chicano Studies major, and of course, then doors just start flying open after that point. That's yeah. Well, I mean, when you got a Chicano Studies, the world's your oyster. You get that Chicano Studies degree. What can't you do?
It just changed.
What's up? What changed?
The world is your oyster. I mean, because that's all the world is.
What's up, Julie 14?
That's the speech I gave my mom when she got that Chicano Studies diploma. What's up?
Julie?
Oh, yeah, I'm here.
Yeah, let's go.
Okay, well, I was wondering. I know that my friend comes from, like, a mentally abusive, like, type of family situation.
Your friend?
Yeah. She's my best friend.
Uh-huh.
And I wanted to know if that had anything to do with her, like, kind of hating herself.
Yes.
Yes, everything.
It does?
Everything. Self-esteem is directly related to the attunement and loving caretaking you receive from your primary caretakers.
That's all you have when you're a kid.
Yeah. Well, that's your whole sense of self is developed from your primary caretakers. And if there's not adequate nourishment given, you're not felt to be worth that nourishment, or if the caretaking is specifically abusive, then you learn that you're worthy of that.
Right.
And that's your sense of self.
What do her parents do to her?
Like, it's her dad and her stepmom, and they scream at her about everything, and they just completely blame her for everything that her sister does and stuff like that.
Why?
She's, like, yelled at constantly.
Is her sister older or younger?
Younger.
Okay. So, Julie.
Yeah.
So, you can be a friend to her. She's going to get caught up in this whole drama, and she's going to start, you know, rebelling against her stepmother and her father, and it can get messy.
Mm.
So, you know what you need to do as a friend? I think you need to try to convince her not to sort of act out. I mean, you get into these vicious cycles, which is her stepmom comes down on her, so she acts out a little more, so her stepmother comes down a little harder on her, which makes her in turn act out even more. Mm. And before you know it, it's that kind of, I've used this analogy a thousand times, but it's the inmate who's going at it with the warden. Who's going to win that battle?
Yeah.
And it's like, take your tray of food and throw it at the guards. Great. Just go down in the tank for six months.
That's right.
Just go into solitary. That's how it works. When you're 14, when you're 15, and you're living at home, and you're going to get into it, that's it. It's a prison, and that's the warden. And here's the deal. Whether you're in prison or whether you're at home with an evil stepmom, you got it. You have your sentence. If she's 15, she's got a 36-month sentence. She's going to be 18. That's when she gets released. In the meantime, kiss some ass. Try to get some try to get a conjugal visit from the boyfriend or something, try to get a job in the PX or wherever, steal some cigarettes and Chiclets. I mean, you know what I mean? Don't ride it out in solitary and laundry detail.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Drew. That's all. I'm out of all my prison analogies.
That's it? No more for tonight?
Yeah. Or
tomorrow you have more.
I'm just saying, you can't...
You mentioned Chiclets, PX.
The more screwed up you... here's the problem. The more you got screwed with as a teenager, the more you want to rebel against everyone around you, mm-hmm. and then the harder they come down on you.
Yeah.
Because your principal, your school teacher, your counselor, your stepmom, they weren't there when you were getting abused.
And the more you see that in everybody around you and bring that down upon you. Not just from your parents, but from everybody.
Right.
Your employer, everybody.
Listen, everybody who got screwed with, why screw with yourself by forcing other people to screw with you later in life? Just make nice. Go to school, get involved with whatever your band practice or whatever sports you're involved with. Stay out at school, come home at 7 at night, say hi to everybody, go in your room, shut the door, eat your Triscuits, beat off, and go to bed.
That's more the kinds of topics you understand.
There
more than jail.
Yeah. All right, let's take a break.
Let's do.
We'll be right back.
If you need help, hang up and then dial.
LoveLine. 1-800-LOVE-191. LoveLine will be right back.
How come he only plays my song once a night?
Your
Hizzle for Chisel song.
Fizzy, Chizzy, Mizzy, Mindy.
That is
Drew's big son.
Yeah. Come on, Mason.
How old is this song? What year is
this? 6 months. This year.
This is 6 months?
It's like Missy Elliott, dude.
No. That's so fun. I figured this was like Jazzy Jeff or something. I don't know.
Drew's like singing the words. He knows the words now.
Yeah, Drew knows it. Kevin?
Yeah.
Hello.
You're 22?
Yep.
What's up?
Well, girlfriend's got the good old-fashioned yeast infection. And,
Is there Morse code coming out of his phone or something?
Yeah, hold on.
Message from the devil there?
Yeah, there's a ship that's taking on water in the North Atlantic. Let me just send out a patrol. I got to send out a seaplane to go look after it. Yeah, go ahead, Kevin.
All right. So, the yeast infection and had unprotected sex during the yeast infection. Is there anything that I can get from that?
I mean, yes.
Yeah, you'll just dry out. Just keep yourself dry.
Don't worry about it. It's not a big deal. Here's the details.
I'm going to have an epileptic seizure if I have to listen to that.
Number one, you could harbor some yeast in your urethra and transmit the yeast back to her. So if she has trouble clearing her infection, it could be because you've got a little bit of that on the tip of the penis. It has no effect on you whatsoever. Very occasionally, you can get a little yeast infection on the penis itself, but you're unlikely to get that. That's a very unusual thing. Then thirdly, you need to make sure that it's actual yeast infection she has, not a vaginitis or some other STD,
mm-hmm.
in which case it can seem like a yeast infection, but you can contract all those things.
All right. Yeah, looking good there, buddy.
Yeah.
Let's talk to Maggie, who's 21. Maggie?
Hi.
Hey. Oh, what's going on?
Sorry, am I too bouncy?
No, it's good. Bouncy.
Okay, so don't think that I'm lame, because I'm really not. I want to, say that first of all. Okay, so I'm 21. I'm home from college for the summer.
Where do you go to school?
USD.
San Diego.
You
ever seen that campus? It's beautiful.
University of San Diego?
Oh, my God. I don't know how they say
it. No, I've never been on there. It's in San Diego State.
It's in... Oh, no. It's on a hill. It's in...
There's the not-so-smart kids.
Is what?
The not-so-smart
kids.
Yeah, I know. It's just... San Diego State, by the way, I mean, that's a four-year junior college over there, and it's so close to the Tijuana border. Now your kid's just going over there and scoring pharmaceuticals and tequila and just getting ripped. I mean, I think it's got to be right up there. There's one of the top five party schools.
Well, I would have to agree with that. It's a nice little spot.
Yeah.
But SC is so beautiful. I mean, it's a beautiful campus.
All right.
Nice kids.
Right.
Quite nice. Yeah.
Go ahead, Megan.
Okay, so I live outside San Francisco, so I go home for the summers because one more year of college, that's
what
I go.
What a tortured life, yes, just to go from San Francisco to San Diego.
Yeah, cry me a river.
Yeah.
But here's my problem. I live in a small town, and there are no guys. at all, and I'm bored out of my mind, and, like, none of my friends came home for the summer, whatever. And I work for this theater company, and I'm, like, I'm the director of the theater company and the stage manager of the productions in it. So everyone who works in the theater is my employee. Mm-hmm. And a lot of the kids that work for the theater go to the high school that I used to go to.
Mm-hmm.
And I have an incredibly cute kid that works for me, and he's 16. And he hasn't really ever hooked up with a girl. He's actually never even kissed a girl.
Mm-hmm.
And the
summer project.
I know technically it's illegal, but
not technically, just flat out.
Okay, yeah. So flat out it is illegal.
Yeah, the law doesn't frown on the ladies doing it to the guys as much as the other way around, though.
And you're in.
I think it's so much more acceptable for it to be an older guy and a younger girl.
Well, it's more acceptable from a social mores standpoint, but I would say less dangerous in terms of the law.
Okay.
You know what I mean? The kid would be less likely to prosecute. His parents would be less likely to prosecute. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. But what about the employee relationship?
Yeah, big deal.
That is a big deal.
I know he's into it.
You're like his teacher.
How do you know he's into it? How do you know he's into it?
We've talked about it.
Oh, my God.
You have.
You're like his teacher.
Like he works on my stage crew, and, like, you know, I take good care of my employees. Like, you know, like,
sure, yeah, evidently.
Show them a good time. But, like,
oh, my God.
No, I haven't acted on it yet. That's what I'm calling
Maggie,
you guys.
You're like the teacher, right?
Well, I'm not a teacher. They're working for me. So I'm not a teacher. I'm a boss.
What production are you guys working on?
We're doing West Side Story.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Which one? Is he a shark or a jet?
No, he's not in it, actually. He's my lighting guy. So I sit in the booth with him all night, and we talk and we flirt. And, like, here's the thing. He's 16 and I'm 21 right now. But it's like, think about how many couples, you know, that are married and are 10 years apart, and it's no big deal. But it matters now.
Why didn't you date him when he was 11 and you were 16?
Hey, shut up.
Yeah, but... Okay? He's 16. But Maggie... That the point is, as you age, that age differential becomes less significant, but it's the same age differential as if he dated an 11-year-old.
Okay.
Yeah. Let me give you an example. When I'm 17, and I'm dating, you know, if I want to date a 12-year-old, she's way too young for me. But if I'm 40 and I'm dating a 35-year-old,
nothing.
She's too old for me.
Right.
I'm a B/C celebrity. I need a 26-year-old.
Yeah, all right.
I mean, it would actually, if you were a 40-year-old celebrity and you were dating a 35-year-old, actually, they would be too old.
Too narrow an age gap.
Only 5 years buffer. All right.
What are we going to say to Maggie?
Maggie, I like her stuff. Yeah. Maggie.
Yes.
You got a big ass?
I do.
All right. Hold on. These are the ramblings of a woman with a big ass. This is they get desperate. They get going this way. She's a big gal. She's gotta make hay while the sun shines, Drew. You understand? As a 16-year-old, she's gonna rock his world.
That's like the crazy effed up 20-year-old male.
All right, but it's gonna be the greatest summer of this kid's life. You know, he's gonna go nuts. Mm. He's going nuts. Maggie.
Yes.
I condone it myself.
Mm. Well, thank you.
God does not ask to see your ID, but here's a question: do you have feelings for him?
Of course I do, but I think it's partially like I'm having the problem with separating that and the fact that, like, he's an amazing kid and he can't deal with girls and he is completely 100% intimidated by them.
Yeah.
And has never even made out with a girl, and he's 16 years old.
You can make out with him. That's not...
You feel like
I could kind of open the gate for him.
Yeah, you could kickstart him.
He could really get some heavy feelings for you.
But he could get weird and start calling you and coming over on his 10-speed and stuff.
Yeah, he may expect something really substantial.
He has a driver's license.
But Maggie, he may really want a significant relationship from you, and if not, you're just exploiting him.
You can't.
Do you guys want to talk to him?
Especially if he's got, hold on.
Something they call goes bogus all of a sudden.
Well, I don't know. All right, should we talk to him?
Yes. Right. It's like a sore.
I'll get on the phone if you want to talk to him.
What? Okay, so he's heard all of this stuff.
Yeah, he's heard part of it.
All right, let's talk to him. What's his name?
Okay, Mike, come here.
Mike.
His name is Mike. He's 16. Here's the phone.
All right.
Hello?
Mike?
Adam?
You're 16?
Yeah.
What year were you born?
1987.
All right. It checks out. You're a virgin?
Yeah.
unfortunately.
Yeah. You have braces?
No, not at all, man.
Okay. But you're a lighting tech guy.
Oh, absolutely.
And you're attracted to Maggie?
Uh-huh. Man, we sit in the booth all night.
Have you guys ever kissed before?
No, I've never actually kissed a girl.
Why don't you try kissing her right now?
Maggie.
Yeah, this is legal.
Maggie.
Whistling?
She ran off behind. She ran to go backstage to deal with some more cleanup.
All right. So she's not around.
Yeah, we just got done with the show.
All right, I'm going to put you on hold. Get her back.
Oh, here she comes. Here she is. Okay. Right here.
All right.
Hey, baby. Hi. All right. So what's up?
All right. Can you guys make out?
Right now, I've never done this before, man.
So hold on a second.
Hold on a second.
This is bogus.
It's bogus.
It's bogus. Guaranteed.
Liar, yeah. Liar,
you know why?
Liar, yeah.
She's got the whole theater crew around the corner listening to this thing go down.
Yeah, you know why? Because guys who've never made out before don't call you man.
Or call her baby. Come here, baby.
Hey, babe. Come here. I've never made out with a girlfriend.
He went from, hey, get over here.
Yeah, too
bitch,
cool. Too cool. Yeah, sorry. Yeah, we don't buy anymore.
Wait, Adam.
No.
Yeah. Was, whatever.
We don't buy it.
Well, he knows he's going to...
Okay, that's fine, man. But can I just say...
She shouldn't have put you on.
No, wait, Adam, hold on one sec. The situation may be bogus, but I actually have never, ever gotten with a girl. Never even kissed.
All right.
Never even kissed.
Never even kissed. And you're 16.
No. Yes.
All right.
But do listen to the voice. Is it...
Doesn't sound
right, does it?
No, okay, I admit I do have a deep voice from my age. That is true. It runs in the family...
No. It's not the depth of the voice. It's a certain quality we hear.
All right. Okay, but listen. It's a bogus call.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, well, look, you never made out with a girl. That's fine. But the premise of the call is bogus. She should have never put him on the phone.
She had us all the way until that.
Right.
Wait, hold on. When I was 15, I had a 22-year-old girlfriend, and that's not bogus.
Yeah.
Yeah, but look what happened.
But she was an alcoholic, and I had to break up with her.
Was she your boss?
She drove a Porsche. She was hot.
Was she your boss?
No. She was like my boss's friend.
Anderson has strange powers over women.
Yes.
You notice that?
Mm-hmm.
The ladies really like Anderson. None of the ladies that work with him. I don't.
I'm husky, so what's up?
You don't have the big head, though. No big head.
Yeah, you don't have.
You get the big calves.
You don't have melon head. You don't have melon head. And you're just I once in a while everything aligns, all the stars come in alignment, and for no good reason. You know what Anderson's like? Anderson's like if you just dumped a whole bunch of crap that didn't taste good into a blender and turned in some sort of delectable smoothie.
That's like one of the greatest, nicest compliments you've ever given me. It's such a great, nice dick.
It's like you take the blender and it's like sour milk, bird crap, an avocado pit, some vinegar, and just a squirt of infant urine.
Pow, it's a flaming
bone. You whip it all up, and somehow you taste it, and it's like, it's pretty good. I got to say, it's not bad.
Well, you're into it.
Yeah, you're kind of into it. That's what it is. All right, we'll take a quick break. We'll be right back.
All right, guys, here's the deal. Looking to hook up?
Call the Dateline.
Sick of wasting time with the wrong person?
Call the Dateline.
One call is all you need to make.
Call the Dateline.
1-877-889-DATE.
You know what I'm saying out there?
Adam and Dr. Drew will be right back on Loveline.
Loveline.
With Adam Carolla and Dr. Drew.
1105 Alternative, San Francisco.
Well, there's the show. Where'd the time go? Gary Busey in here tomorrow night with his partner and my good friend, Adam De La Pena, was from The Man Show, and now he's from I'm with Busey. So we'll talk to them tomorrow night. That'll be interesting because Gary keeps getting crazier. So here's where we're on. 311, Les and Jake coming up later this week. And until next time, this is Adam Carolla for Dr. Drew saying mahalo.
All that matters is about you, Phil. So Adam's question was quite pertinent.
Thank you, Drew.
The only thing that matters...
Total vindication. Thank you, Dr. Drew.
This has been Loveline. The opinions expressed on this show are not necessarily those of the staff, management, sponsors, or this station. The producer for Loveline is Ann Ingold. Loveline is a presentation of Westwood One Entertainment.